Celebrated film director and writer Shyam Benegal is a man who has wrestled with complex historical and social issues with the deft ease. But even a man of his vast experience felt he was wading in deep waters when he wanted to tell the story of India's birth, the crucial moments when Constitution was written.
Long years ago, we made a tryst with destiny.
It was felt that it probably would be a good idea to have a series on the making of the Indian Constitution, the story behind how the democratic constitution of India was created, with all the people who were involved in the creation of that. Of course, I jumped at it because I said it would probably make an exciting program.
He wanted to explore the personality and the psyche of the man who shaped the document that today dictates each citizen's life in India. Dr. Bhimrav Ramji Ambedkar, or Baba Sahib Ambedkar, as he is popularly called now, was a towering personality who steered the Constituent Assembly that wrote the central law book of India and left a huge footprint on India as a nation. When offered, Shyam Benegal accepted this challenging assignment with his customary zeal to tell the untold stories behind the epic historical events.
This assembly resolves Honorable Dr. B.R. Ambedkar be appointed. Those for the motion say aye.
Aye.
The motion is adopted.
When a group of interpret reformers began fighting the British colonizers and trying to wrest India free from a coercive foreign rule of more than 100 years, there was one man who did something even more revolutionary. If trying to eject the British was a courageous task that only a brave heart could undertake, fighting the caste system was akin to finding a pervasive ghost. Only a maverick would do that. The founding fathers of the first Indian government picked just this eclectic figure to take up the task of writing the Constitution of India.
Asli imtihan to ab aayega jawahar jab hame apni sarkar banani aur chalani padegi.
Hum tayar hai Bapu. Jagjivan Ram ji ka bhi naam hamare fehrist mein hai.
Aur Ambedkar. वो मेरा पुराना विरोधी है पर ये बात भी सच है कि संविधान और कानून के बारे में जितना वो जानता है शायद कोई जानता हो पूरे देश में और अगर आपने अंबेडकर के ज्ञान और अनुभव का फायदा नहीं उठाया तो नुकसान उसका नहीं हिंदुस्तान का होगा
It also shows how Gandhi thought, because he said none of the other people would have the vision and the farsightedness of a person like Ambedkar.
Ambedkar was a multi-layered personality, an active social reformer, a practicing lawyer, a grassroots politician, and a thought leader. But this did not make the battle of consensus and lawmaking any easier for him. The series scriptwriter Shama Zaidi dived into historical documents and extensive cache of contemporaneous records to capture the inch-by-inch fight by Ambedkar to shape a visionary and a reformist constitution that India has today.
Ambedkar had been to an American university, so his ideas were much more modern than, and only now you realize, you know, he was ahead of his time, and now people are appreciating what he was trying to say then.
portraying a real person, that too a well-recognized figure for whom their strong public opinions is a tough task for any actor. Sachin Khedekar, a mainstream artist from Hindi film industry in Mumbai, felt the challenge from the onset.
As an actor, it was a huge responsibility. I had that pressure of being at my best.
Mr. President, sir, I am surprised at this statement of Mr. Tyagi. Rights of minorities should be absolute rights.
It was a project which was very challenging because there were over 152 characters. When it came to the costumes for Ambedkar, one could see what costumes he was wearing when. One could see that he went out of his way to dress very formally. He wore lots of suits when he went out in a formal space.
Mr. President, sir, coming as I do from a community that has produced Dr. Ambedkar, I feel proud that his capacity has been recognized now, not only by the Harijans, but by all communities that inhabit India.
I had worked with Mr. Benegal, so I knew his style, quest for authenticity, and his own approach to this entire document and the making of the Constitution.
I'm quite convinced that given time and circumstances, nothing in the world will prevent this country from becoming one.
Our Constitution has a wonderful preamble. The way it itself, the way it starts, saying that we are one. All of us, this great diversity of this country. Now, this is something that is so beautifully drafted.
We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political.
The set was probably as authentic, the 300 members where we are speaking there, and it's about 10-minute odd speech. And when he says humbly that this is our document we are presenting to ourselves, it's a great moment of pride for him and the entire nation. And his entire happiness or a sense of fulfillment comes into that speech. And I really think that is by far my my good performances, let's not say. But I'm really overwhelmed. It gives me goosebumps every time I see those scenes.
Equality of status and of opportunity.
Since he was the editor or the main person who put the Constitution together, he was the chairman of the committee, he had to make the concluding remarks. And what he said is still true. I think that's a classic speech.
This 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this Constitution.
To give voice to the voiceless is an aspect of genuine democracy. And that was something he was very aware of. The whole idea was that everybody has equal rights. Indian Constitution is designed in that fashion.
You know, Mooknayak in Marathi, there's a whole lot of connotations to that word. Main unki awaaz ban sakta hoon, is what Mooknayak is all about. Ambedkar had constantly in his mind, and he actually created avenues to hear people.
As Ambedkar set out to make sure that the Constitution speaks for the silent, Ambedkar too faced resistance and reticence from his colleagues. Ambedkar was like a bitter dose that worked to cure years of bias and prejudice that had piled up in the Indian ecosystem. He made a frontal attack on the caste system in his first draft of laws. This rattled even senior and seasoned leaders, but they were unable to sway Ambedkar from his quest. And if his colleagues tried harder, Ambedkar was ready with his dreaded resignation letter. This interaction between Sardar Patel, the first Home Minister of India, and Ambedkar, the first Law Minister of India, speaks for itself.
Munshi ji ki baaton se aap naraaz ho gaye, Bhimrao?
Lekin wo to aapki baat lekar aaye the mere paas. Isiliye maine kaha ki main hi drafting committee se hat jata hu.
आप तो जानते हैं कांग्रेस क्या पूरे भारत में दूसरा और कोई है ही नहीं जो हमारे संविधान को आकार दे सके. खुद बापू भी यही कहा करते थे.
लेकिन आप उनकी बात मानते कहां हैं पटेल जी? गांधी जी पिछड़ों को रिजर्वेशन देने की मेरी तजवीज से सहमत थे. अरे एक बार हमें अपने बराबर आने का मौका तो दीजिए पटेल जी, फिर देखिए कैसे हम आगे निकल जाते हैं. और ये काम बिना आरक्षण के नहीं होगा. अगर फिर भी मेरी बातें आपको जहरीली लग रही हैं तो मैंने अपना इस्तीफा तैयार रखा है, आप खुद लेते जाइएगा.
मैं बड़ा जिद्दी आदमी हूं अंबेडकर जी, लेकिन मूर्ख नहीं हूं, किसान हूं. देखकर ही बता सकता हूं कि कौन सा बीज कल मुझे अच्छी फसल देगा.
That scene is key. The all-inclusiveness of those leaders is something which is extremely powerful and endearing. Unless and until they all come together, they would have never created this document. It's impossible.
Today, Ambedkar is loved or hated and mistakenly remembered largely for introducing reservation quotas in education and jobs. But in fact, Ambedkar was a great believer in merit and had suggested reservation only for a period of first 10 years.
Reservation he demanded was until they would be equal to the others, meaning in terms of opportunities. If the opportunities given to them would be equal to others, that's when reservations must stop. He was thinking in terms of an egalitarian society. He was not using this as loaves and fishes to bribe people.
Yeah. Floundering in the darkness of Dalit discrimination, Ambedkar's belief in merit was like a torchlight for his followers. Sumit Samos was born in a small village in the tribal district of Koraput in Odisha. Ambedkar helped Sumit not only to become an articulate ambassador for Dalit rights, but also a youth icon who voices his messages packaged within rap songs.
Dalit boy. Janam liya maine jab se tab se tabba gunegar laga mujh pe fat se poochta sawal main tujhse kyun hazar jaate hain itne sare saalon se gulamon ke bazaar mein tu kehta hum azad hain insano ki jhund mein kyun upar niche bhag hai. जवाब तेरे पास पर करेगा नहीं कुछ भी क्योंकि असली गुनहगार है मेरी जीने की वजह जो है वो दिखता तेरे गालियों में आधी रात आजादी तेरी छप्पर फूंकती बस्तियों में.
The basis of my rap is Ambedkar. You know, I'm just paraphrasing Ambedkar in different ways in whatever I sing. The ideas that I use in my songs are mostly based on Ambedkar, and Ambedkar is someone who brings out a lot of mixed, you know, a lot of emotions, especially for the Dalits of this country who look up to him as someone who has given them a new lease of life.
Bata do hame agar bacha hai kuch aur kya kya dekhe bas itna hi kahunga mar ke bhi jeena hai hum ladai seekh le mar ke bhi jeena hai hum ladai seekh le.
So strong was Ambedkar's belief in education as a means to rid discrimination that he asked the Dalit community to focus single-mindedly on getting schooled.
He also told Dalits that education is a weapon. With education you can transform the society. He says education is like the milk of the tigress, you know, you'll roar, that will make you conscious. And it is all because of Ambedkar, of that one line, okay, educate, agitate and organize.
Eta dino hela mukichi kou no thili mo chup chap thili kintu ta mane nuo ki mukichi koi baku chau no thili. Eta dino hela mukichi kou no thili mo chup chap thili kintu ta mane nuo ki mukichi koi baku chau no thili.
I think Ambedkar is a global thought leader. Because you see, let's say, like I take inspiration from Malcolm X or Martin Luther King, and they spoke against some kind of a segregation in the society. I would put Ambedkar even in a higher pedestal. Ambedkar is
message. It's for billion, like 1.2 billion of Indians. So I think you'd be at the topmost global thought leaders.
Right after independence, when it came to the question of making laws about electoral system, Gandhi and Ambedkar had a fiery clash. Ambedkar wanted a separate electorate for the depressed classes, but Gandhi refused to divide the Indian society on caste basis and went on a fast unto death to protest against Ambedkar's suggestion.
आप अपनी जिद छोड़ क्यों नहीं देते गांधी जी? अगर आपको कुछ हो गया, तो आपके शिष्य मुझे बेकार में इल्जाम देंगे।
हिंदू संप्रदाय ने हरिजनों को सदियों से अछूत बना के रखा है, पर अब जब मौका आया है कि राजनीतिक रूप से दोनों साथ साथ आ सकें, तो आप क्यों हरिजनों के लिए अलग चुनावी व्यवस्था की मांग कर रहे हैं?
मेरी तजवीज ये है कि हम हर बार कुछ ऐसी सीटें तय करें जिनमें हर एक को केवल हरिजन कैंडिडेट ही चुनने होंगे, फिर वो खुद चाहे किसी भी वर्ग वर्ण के क्यों ना हो, और बाकी सीटों पे भी हरिजन को उसी तरह से खड़े रहने का अधिकार होगा जैसे कि किसी भी हिंदुस्तानी को।
मुझे सोचने के लिए थोड़ा वक्त चाहिए होगा गांधी जी।
अंबेडकर में हैव वन और लॉस्ट मेनी स्मॉल स्कर्मिशेस, बट इन सिक्योरिंग द लीगल राइट्स ऑफ बैकवर्ड क्लासेस इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड इन लॉकिंग द बार्न डोर्स अगेंस्ट प्रेजुडिस एंड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, अंबेडकर मेड अ हिस्टोरिक कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू इंडिया and all its citizens.
Social conscience is the only safeguard of all rights, fundamental or non-fundamental.
In Article 14, 15, 16, 17, he speaks about, you cannot be discriminated on the basis of caste, sex, religion. And I think that is what has changed after Ambedkar, which was not there before Ambedkar.
Provision in the constitution given by Baba Sahib for the oppressed representation. Academics, media, bureaucracy, justice system, private sector, politics, cinema and journalism, bunch of few top class.
Mooknayak was not just the name of a journal that Ambedkar published in order to convey his ideas on empowerment. Mooknayak, a man who strives and speaks for the silent, was the central theme of his life. Ambedkar drafted the Hindu Code Bill that tried to bring in equal rights for women in inheritance, maintenance, divorce and remarriage. Way ahead of his times, he strongly fought for reforms in women-related laws and even resigned from his cabinet post as law minister when he was not able to persuade the Indian parliament to accept what may have seemed revolutionary ideas to lawmakers of that time.
The women's issue is why he left the government. Basically, it was he wanted all the pro-women aspects to come in, which the reactionaries were not willing to admit. But the women were very supportive and they all wanted, especially Rajkumari Amrit Kaur.
Shadi, aurat aur mard, dono ki hami se ho. Aur vaivahik jeevan mein dono ka saman hak aur barabar ki marzi ho. Ye nukta fundamental rights mein aana chahiye.
Aana to chahiye, par mard manenge kahan?
Main committee ko foran ek chitthi likh deti hoon. Phir dekhte hain. तुम्हारे और मेरे अलावा कौन इस मामले में हमारा साथ देता है?
मर तो शायद ही कोई साथ दे हमारा।
अंबेडकर वाज अ वेरी मॉडर्न मैन। ही वाज अ वेरी कंटेम्पररी मॉडर्न ह्यूमन बीइंग। He started in politics as a leader of his particular community, but he outgrew that. Only somebody who had educated himself, who had become a very contemporary, modern world citizen. The classic quality of Ambedkar.
He wanted a right to marriage as a fundamental right. It's still not there, but this is what he had wanted. And he, in fact, even wanted illegitimate children to have rights on property, which was not given in the Constitution.
I propose that there should be no difference between legitimate and illegitimate children as far as laws of inheritance are concerned.
पर इस तरह क्या हम शादी जैसी संस्था पर ही प्रश्नचिन्ह नहीं लगा देंगे?
For that matter, all the personal laws are not in our purview here.
This is about children and their rights. And you, Diwan Sahab, are a learned man. And you know what Shakespeare says about this question of legitimate and illegitimate.
अब शेक्सपियर का जवाब देना थोड़ा मुश्किल हो जाता है तो एक काम करते हैं इस विषय पे वोट कर लेते हैं Those in favor of Dr. Ambedkar's proposal, please raise your hands. छह विपक्ष में केवल तीन पक्ष में
From Hindu Code Bill to all-inclusiveness of women, which we are still struggling for, is, I think, ahead of time and a great respect for women. I mean, it would only come out of that.
Ginni Mahi, a new voice of Dalit pop in the country, is a YouTube sensation with close to 100,000 followers. Quoting freely from Ambedkar's speeches, Ginni's songs talk of a place where the sun shines equally for all.
अगर आज मैं भी कुछ कर पा रही हूँ या देश की हर नारी कुछ कर पा रही है अपनी फील्ड में कुछ भी कर रही है, तो ये देन है डॉक्टर बी.आर. अंबेडकर बाबा साहिब जी की मेरे हर एक सॉन्ग में कोई ना कोई मोटिव होता है मतलब उस सॉन्ग के थ्रू मैं कुछ ना कुछ बाबा साहिब जी के बारे में बताना चाहती हूँ
Identity and empowerment are integral ideas behind Ginni's lyrics and music. Most of these are shaped by Ambedkar's thought and his work. She says, very few people know that it was Ambedkar who set out key labor laws detailing rights of employees and critical issues like 8-hour work shift, medical leave, minimum wages, and equal pay for equal work.
पहले के समय में ऐसा होता था कि पुरुष काम कर सकते थे और औरतें काम नहीं कर सकती थी जब लेडीज ने भी काम करना शुरू किया तो उसमें भी थोड़ा होता था कि पुरुषों को ज़्यादा पैसा दे देते थे और थोड़ा उनको लेडीज़ को कम मिलती थी लेकिन इस चीज़ को भी डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर जी ने ख़त्म किया
द सिटीजन्स मेन एंड वुमेन इक्वली हैव द राइट टू एन एडिक्वेट मीन्स ऑफ लाइवलीहुड दैट देयर इज इक्वल पे फॉर इक्वल वर्क फॉर बोथ मेन And women.
He looked into the future to create what is essentially an egalitarian constitution. If you look at our constitution and compare it with a lot of constitutions of that period, you'll find how remarkable it is.
Many young artists across India are investing their creative energies in spreading the seeds sown by Dr. Ambedkar. Artists like Mari Selvaraj, Ravi Kumar Anand, Meena Kandasamy, Sukirtha Rani and Palani Muthu Sivakami from Tamil Nadu, Aravind Malagatti, Siddhalingayya, Chandrashekhar Bhandari, Koti Ganahalli Ramayya from Karnataka, Aruna Gokulamanda, Gogu Shamala, Jupaka Shubhadra from Telangana, Dr. C.S. Chandrika, Vijila Chirappad from Kerala, have been taking the thoughts of Dr. Ambedkar to farthest corners of India. In a time when it's difficult to get endorsement from young millennials, Dr. Ambedkar is a figure that is invoking renewed admiration and adulation. During his lifetime and even many years after India's independence, the contributions of Dr. Ambedkar did not get the spotlight they deserved. Now in recent years, Government of India under Prime Minister Narendra Modi has paid unique homage to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar.
Baba Sahab ka rashtra nirman mein jo yogdan hai, us wajah se hum sabhi Baba Sahab ke rani hai. Hamari sarkar ka ye prayas hai ki jyada se jyada logon tak उनके विचार पहुंचे, विशेषकर युवा पीढ़ी उनके बारे में जाने, उनका अध्ययन करे, और इसलिए इस सरकार में बाबा साहब के जीवन से जुड़े महत्वपूर्ण स्थलों को तीर्थ के रूप में विकसित किया जा रहा है। जय भीम Jai Bhim!
Creating five memorials or Panchatirth in memory of his tremendous contribution. The present government has put a spotlight on Dr. Ambedkar's life and his ideas. Bhima Janma Bhumi Memorial in Madhya Pradesh pays respect to the place where he was born. Ambedkar Shiksha Bhumi Memorial in London salutes the places where he as a student honed his ideas of an equitable polity. Deeksha Bhumi Memorial in Nagpur pays respect to the place where he launched social reforms. Mahaparinirvana Memorial in Delhi, where Dr. Ambedkar died, and Chaitya Bhumi Memorial in Mumbai, where he was cremated, have become venerated spots to revisit Dr. Ambedkar's enlightened writing and exemplary life.